Welcome back. Doctor Who is marvellous, isn't it? We're now approaching the end of day one of our anniversary weekend. We hope your enjoyment quotient has been maximised. There is no doubt Doctor Who has been a great benefit to generations of galaxies, but why aren't his adventures made for television anymore? Let's look at what led to the TV Lords giving up on the world's favourite Time Lord 14 years ago.
Doctor Who in the 1980s was a very bad period. Colin Baker was the Doctor. I wouldn't go so far as to say he was miscast, but there were a lot of bad decisions. For instance, he had a terrible costume.
The costumes were entirely inappropriate because I had this vast multicoloured monstrosity on which I never really cared for.
Very neat. I mean, there's nothing at all incongruous about that.
The storytelling was becoming very lazy, dwelling on its own continuity.
What happened?
It's a little disagreement with our tin friends.
Everything looked a bit bland.
Not for long, I hope.
Colin was kind of treated a little bit badly. He arrived just as the series was being criticised by the BBC for being violent and for being over the top. And he came in and was given a rather violent and over the top character to play.
It was becoming increasingly difficult to make the show to the kind of standard they wanted to make because the budget was not being increased each year in line with inflation.
That shouldn't have happened.
And then they made a fatal mistake. They changed the format. You see, Doctor Who had always been 25 minutes on Saturday afternoon.
I'm not sure that's enough.
It zipped along, you see. You got 25 minutes and you didn't stop to draw breath kind of thing. You crammed a lot into it.
You must forget how I used to be. I'm a Time Lord. A man of science, temperament, and passion.
And a very loud voice.
It had become far too pantomime-y, too light entertainment.
I think it got a little bit camp, and it was became a little less believable.
Really? Could also have something to do with the lack of support.
It has to be said that there was a vociferous fan base criticising it as well, sending in an awful lot of correspondence, which frankly the BBC isn't geared up to deal with.
So let's find out what the real diehard fans think of the new series. Graham Wood.
It was a very complicated plot. I think possibly too complicated for the average viewer.
It was also very cliched. It was very routine, running up and down corridors and silly monsters.
So it just reached a point where the show ended.
The 6 o'clock news from the BBC.
Doctor Who is to take a rest. The BBC announced today that the Time Lord, who's been on our screens for some 22 years now,
who will be off the air for 18 months. The controller of BBC One, Michael Grade, made the decision a month before the new series was due to start production.
I don't think I've ever misjudged anybody quite as badly.
I don't think Michael Grade personally liked the series.
Michael Grade's kind of gained a reputation as being the kind of nemesis of Doctor Who fans.
If I was in charge of something, I might have personal preferences, I might not like it, but I'd still put it on because that's what people want.
The Doctor Who Appreciation Society is up in arms. They've called the decision horrifying and staggering.
This did cause an uproar both in the press and with the fans, and there were campaigns through several national newspapers to save Doctor Who. I did the odd thing. I wrote to my MP, I wrote to the Radio Times.
Fans worldwide, weren't they, were trying to all club together and, you know, release charity singles.
Doctor in Distress was a very, very quickly made single with Colin Baker and Nicola Bryant and various pop stars of the day.
B-list celebrities.
It was made in the cancellation crisis in 1985, originally with the idea that it would be so popular it would raise money to show the BBC that they should make a new series.
Send in the money. Please, we'll pay for it.
I don't think it got much airtime, to be honest. It wasn't terribly good.
Because it was an appalling travesty of music, it didn't really make a lot of money, so they just donated it to charity.
Doctor in distress. SOS. Doctor in distress.
such was the outcry when people thought Doctor Who had been cancelled for good that they had to very quickly say it will be back.
But a spokesman stressed that the current series would not be the last.
I think from then on, Doctor Who was living on borrowed time.
What have you done? I think poor old Colin never quite made the impression he should have done.
Excellent.
The series was declining in popularity a little bit.
Excellent.
So he sort of got tarred with the brush of failure when I think actually, in many ways, he was a very, very good doctor.
Yes.
Unfortunately, the public, or maybe the press, didn't see it that way.
Didn't go very well, did it?
And then Colin got the boot.
I remember getting a letter from Colin Baker. Yes. I brought him to school, I was very excited. This is when Colin was axed. And I think I'd written a fan letter to him just around the time that he was axed, and he must have got this on the day that he found out, because he sent me this letter just bemoaning the BBC. I still got it somewhere.
I make no apology for having enjoyed playing the Doctor. As to what he did to my career, well, in terms of being typecast, my feeling is it's better to be typecast than not cast.
The BBC's most widely travelled Doctor emerged from his TARDIS with a new face today. The actor Sylvester McCoy is to take over the role of Doctor Who from the last Time Lord, Colin Baker. Mr. McCoy is the seventh man to defy the laws of time, space and mortality.
I'm the only actor who's played two Doctors. I played Doctor Who number six, because I had to regenerate from Colin into Doctor Who number seven.
Sylvester had quite a hard time because he'd started off with this pantomime character of the Doctor where it hadn't been written specifically for him.
Yes, well, you could be right. I wanted to bring back that mystery and uncertainty that had been the early Doctor's role.
I think he had a big job of getting Doctor Who, in the public's mind, back on the rails after that turbulent time.
Strange business.
Sylvester McCoy was one of the best Doctors over the years, but I think he was let down by stories.
Budget constraints and special effects that were often dreadful.
What became a pantomime version of It's All Myself?
The dragon's supposed to be guarding a fabulous treasure.
Oh, treasure? What treasure?
We're not talking to you.
I don't think you got half of what you would get from Tom Baker clowning around like that. It would have been X years ago, I think, if he'd tried to bring that out in the 70s.
By the time we hit the third season and we were doing presenting a much more powerful, much darker Doctor, I think we were really beginning to hit our stride.
I dreamed that one day everything would come right.
The schedulers then decided to try and put it up against Coronation Street.
When you move a programme that's been on basically for about 20 years to different time slots all over the place, competing against popular programmes on ITV, I think you've got to wonder, do the BBC have much faith in it anymore?
It's a dead man.
And I think it's a number of these factors which all came together which made the BBC say, right, well, that's it.
Why do you think the BBC axed Doctor Who after Sylvester?
Have you seen them?
It's very difficult to say what actually was responsible for killing Doctor Who without slagging off a particular person, i.e. the producer, John Nathan Turner.
I don't think we intend to make things over complex, but at the same time, I do think we attempt to challenge our audience.
John was a very good producer in many ways, but I don't think he was good at stories.
What would you like to ask the producer, Graham?
To see stories that begin with a beginning, have a middle and have an end.
Oh!
They'll certainly take on board the points.
He got the whole feeling of the show wrong.
Yes.
It's a shame that it ended when it did. I think that another season could have kind of set the seal on it and really could have shown what Sylvester was capable of.
I sympathise with your disappointment!
I always think of Doctor Who a bit like Monty Python. The BBC are happy to bring them in the world and they're happy to nurture them, but they don't perhaps clutch them to their bosom. And then later on, because of the way these programmes are and the way they have this appeal and effect and allure on fans, they become great programmes and sooner or later are assimilated back into the BBC as bona fide classics. And I think it's almost despite the BBC rather than because of it.
One day, we return home. I shall erect colossal statues in your honour.
That's it for today. That's for day one. Never mind, there's plenty more where that came from tomorrow, including all of this. 12 hours of Doctor Who from 7 a.m. tomorrow, here on UK Gold. I wish you a good night.